And at the end of the day, at least if you stand up yourself, one person, two people, three people, 15 people, you would say you didn't bury your head in the sand, that you gave it a good shot, that you gave it a shot for your parents, that you gave it a shot for your children, that you gave it a shot for their children. That you stood up, that you said no, that you didn't bury your head in the sand because you knew it was wrong. And this whole country needs to start doing that. All over the country, not just in Dublin. There's enough people in Dublin, God knows, not enough of them care either. People say we voted them into power. We voted them into power like we do every single time because we're promised a bunch of lies. We are told A, B, and C is going to happen and every single one of them get reneged on every time. We were told not one hospital was going to close. In 1994, Enda Kenny publicly said it would be unjust and morally wrong to track a person's home. And look what's happening. Lawyer. All we get is lies when eventually they come. We've got the elections, they go around the streets, they visit Limerick, Cork, Dublin, they come out, they shake hands with the mature of us, they shake hands with the baby. And we say it's big right. Now, do we see those politicians in the space of 4 years ever again off the street shaking anyone's hands? No, we don't. Sir Cozy might have the pleasure, but that's about it. And again, this is wrong. We need to stand up, we need to unite, we need to stop laughing at people who are standing up. It's very easy to criticise people for trying to make change. It's very easy to say you couldn't do this or you couldn't do that or why didn't you do that or why didn't you come over there or why didn't you do this. At the end of the day, boys, we're doing something. And if people have any suggestions or people have ideas or people need anything brought to the attention or people need help and support, they can come up and they can talk to us and they can put it to us. Face to face.
This, on the other hand,
because online, it's great and easy to press like. It's great and easy to criticise in the comfort of your own armchair.
Don't drink that much.
It doesn't require a lot of balls, though. And that's what we need in this country. We need people to fight. Your spirit again. Find your souls. Use that fear and use that anger and use that disappointment to the government to turn it around. Get out of the streets every Saturday and join us around 1:30. Join us for our march. Bring your sign saying whatever you want. Bring a sign saying your entire story on it if you want. Get up here and tell us your story. Tell the people your story. Because we're listening. We want to know. We're feeling what's going on in this country. We're knowing that if change doesn't happen now, it is going to go to rack and roll in the next 10 years. And we won't have an option anymore. There will be no money. There'll be no money in Europe, there'll be no money in Ireland. And we need to send that future, get ready for it. In whatever way that is, or whatever shape or form that takes. And we can turn a blind eye now. Kind of carry on, Jerry, the head of the sand. It's reasonably okay for the next 2 or 3 years. And then the shit's going to hit the fan. This is going in the next 10 years. And it's not going to change. Because it's happening the world over, domino effect. Like we said, in the next 30 years, 70% of the world's countries are going to be absolutely bankrupt. And what do you do then? Money would become worth nothing. At the moment, only one out of every $10 in existence is even real money. Back in 1913, the Federal Reserve were given permission to print money. That 100-year lease is coming up in December of this year. So we have the option as a people to decide what's going to happen then. Do we want to be ruled by the Federal Reserve for another 100 years, or do we want a new system? A system that's real. If you've got a Federal Reserve printing out money to countries with interest constantly, every single country in this world can never be out of debt. It doesn't make any sense. At the same time, back in those days, your dollar or whatever currency you had was legitimately worth a certain percentage of gold or silver if you brought it into a bank. Back in 1963, they did away with all that. But technically now, your money is worth nothing, but the paper is written on. So if you go into a bank, you cannot physically exchange your money for anything. You've got virtual debts building up with people buying those virtual debts, passing them on to other debts, with interest going on along the way. And it's one big joke. Again, like we said, except real people are getting hurt. Real families are getting hurt. Entire countries are getting hurt. The Marines have been out protesting, lighting things on fire, and saying no for the last couple of weeks. We have to going. We're doing nothing. And they're saying no, at the end of the day, if you call the country up, if it gets to the stage where you've got enough people who care, and you've got people saying, we're not going to pay the household charges, we're not going to pay water taxes, we're not going to pay any tax, frankly. Cut them off where it hurts. If you've got a city in the country united enough to say, you know what, half this country cannot afford to pay its mortgage, cut them off for a month. Don't pay your mortgage. The entire country don't pay their mortgage for a month or two, or don't pay their loan. And see if the government listens then. See if that's the way to move the small business. Because the thing is, we have the power. And I know it's a widely used catchphrase with the 99% and the 1% and the 99% people saying no to the 1%, but the fact is, it's true. If you've got 99% of a nation and a world and a country and a community that are unhappy, then how are 1% of people allowed to control that? How is that being allowed? And what are we going to do to stop it? Again, we've got fantastic minds in this country. We've got wit and humour, we've got empathy. We can look after each other if we wanted to, and it really doesn't take that much, to be honest. You go to your back, you inform yourself, you inform other people of what's going on, their rights, read your constitution. The constitution is going to be drafted up again apparently in the next year or two. What do we want as a nation going into the constitution? How do we want our country run? What do we see as being a decent way to treat its people and its country instead of being told? Democracy literally means group demonstration, mob rule, group gathering.
Sleep, not in the fucking thing.
This is democracy. Not the Dáil. Not the IMF. Not the EU. A one-world government is first going to sort everything out. It's going to make it a lot easier for the 1% to get away with everything when they're controlling everything. If we've got countries crippled and starting wars over oil dependency, then should we not be asking ourselves, why are we dependent on oil? When there's been alternative technologies going around for about the last 140 years that aren't being implemented because everything is controlled by the oil companies now. Everything. Even the massive solar cell farms and the massive wind farms going up right across the States and Germany and Italy now are all being funded by the oil companies with 60-70% stakes in any profit. So either way, it's a win-win. Are we going to let this continue? When you inform yourself and know yourself, it's very hard to turn back on it. For anyone who has an iPhone on this street, for anyone who owns Xbox, for anyone who owns an Xbox, a PlayStation, the iPhone, I'll just give you a bit of information up right there for you. Now, Apple is a fantastic company by all means. They've got great headquarters in the States, fantastic physics. Apparently, it's great work at the moment in the States. But if you look at where those phones are actually being made and produced, not the in China, the workers are living in conditions that barely come off their heads and barely have enough room to move. The workers that actually make those iPhones are kept in worse conditions than battery heads. They work in buildings where they try and commit suicide on a daily basis. 300 people stood at the edge of a building 3 weeks ago in China wanting to kill themselves. And instead of improving the conditions for the workers, they installed suicide nets on the side of the building. Again, I ask of you, is that acceptable? We need to start being more responsible for the products we buy, where they're being made from, the same with our food and everything else. Because at the end of the day, saying that you didn't know isn't good enough anymore. With the Facebook and Twitter and the radio, we know. We just know what to know.